The CFO has guided that growth won't be as good going into the second half of the year, and there's going to be pressure on net interest margin. Can you guide us, Shaikha, this morning in terms of what growth we can expect in the second half and what kind of net interest margin is on the agenda? Good morning.
Hi, good morning, Venice. Well, basically, as you rightly said, our revenue growth has clearly decelerated relative to previous periods, and that's mainly a result of the strong base year effect. Last year saw exceptionally solid growth trends across all lines of business. We saw volume growth, margin expansion, and very strong fee-based growth. This immediately posed a challenge for us to be able to grow this year. That said, we still delivered year-on-year growth in all profitability lines and continued to build our loan book, and this will be helping us to restore the strong growth trends in the future. But going forward, as you mentioned, I mean, when we assess the factors driving our growth, we look beyond the quarter trends. From that perspective, we remain very confident that the strong profitability drivers that we saw in the past couple of years are still intact. So in a simple words, we are a diversified group, so we have several contributors to our revenue stream, both by business and by businesses and geographies. Our expansion strategy has been in place for a long time. So going forward, we do not carry any consolidation or integration risk. On the contrary, all our geographies are turning into mature businesses, and our focus now is on how to generate more contribution from that diversified market. I'm very positive and opportunities in 2019 for the bank in the region is great because of our diversification, as I mentioned, and across all operations. Our digital agenda is a priority, as we see in the future of banking. Investing in technology will help us increase our penetration in some markets and solidify our market share and increase customer loyalty in others.
Yep. So it's Tracy Alloway here in Hong Kong. You mentioned some other markets, and one of the bright spots in your results for the first half was international operations, which accounted for something like 26% of first half profits. Mm-hmm. Do you have any more international expansion plans? Might you be looking, for instance, at Saudi wealth management or maybe building up your expansion in China? And which of those options would you prefer?
Yeah, well, basically, the focus is on our long-term strategy. We have a clear strategy that focuses on creating value for the shareholders. And basically, I think you agree with me that I cannot, discuss publicly the information which is not available to the public. So let me just focus on the NBK strategy. As you rightly mentioned, outside Kuwait, we generally focus on growth markets, namely Egypt and KSA, where we see a significant opportunity for growth. In Egypt, the retail segment is a key potential for our operation there as target higher growth levels in the segment as the country continues to deliver improving macroeconomic trends. In Saudi, we started operation in our new branches and targeting the wealth management business through our newly established CMA license company that will be well positioned to leverage MBK's global network and wealth management offerings to penetrate the segment in the Saudi market. Of course, China is MBK China is a great opportunity for us, and basically the target is to attract the business of Chinese companies, mainly contractors and other
Shaikha, it's Manus. Shaikha, we very clearly understand the ambitions. Mm-hmm. I think it's very clear for anybody who tracks the company. What we really want to understand from you, for example, were you going to do the heavy lifting of the business in Kuwait? I'm thinking about Kuwait Petroleum, Shaikha. Are you arranging any loans for Kuwait Petroleum's expansion? Are you helping out the national project there? And if so, what kind of size of loan book might you proffer to Kuwait Petroleum?
For your information, I mean, NBK is the relationship bank of the KPC and its subs. And we managed the mega projects within the oil sector. And basically, the project finance segment in Kuwait is led by NBK. And we always get involved in their mega projects in Kuwait and outside Kuwait, not just in Kuwait, like, you know, Duqm project, which is a refinery in Oman and other places in Vietnam and other market. So we dominate the foreign corporate business in Kuwait as well as the oil sector. So basically, MBK Capital is the advisor of KPC, and they are in direct contact with them to work with them on the funding of their ambitious strategy within the coming 5 years.
So, Shaikha, I wonder if you could help Manus and myself clear up some confusion in the market as well. There was at one point some talk that you were bidding for a credit fund run by the erstwhile Abraj. Are you still in the running for that fund? Are there still Abraj assets that you're interested in?
Yeah, this is NBK Capital and not NBK. It was an opportunity. They looked at it, and it's a closed subject for us. No, we are not interested in this opportunity.